I think this is a great game. I love the concept of Mega Man
I'll
2.
Take that out.
Bump up your mic by 5%, Phil.
So you go from this
to this.
That's like a huge difference, though. That's not even
it's a huge difference. Like, originally you're like this.
But you could be like this.
What do I have to do to become Nico the less flamboyant?
The most important question is, do you have Mega Man 2.5D?
No. I thought this was going to be in 12 hours from now, so...
No, it's right now.
I'm pregnant.
Just download the game, I don't give a shit.
Fellon, congratulations!
Who's the father?
Yeah.
Nico.
It's gonna be one ugly motherfucker, I'll tell you that much.
We had trouble delivering the baby. Apparently the sunglasses got in the way.
No, the coat hanger had something to do with
it. Oh.
Wow, this got dark fast.
There are better games at 1/100th of the size of this.
It's better to lose a lover than to love a loser.
What defines a loser?
It was nice knowing you, Altima.
Are you breaking up with me?
He asks with his mouth full of food.
Are you breaking up
with me? I'm from Texas.
Is Altima recording? Because I could do everything to speed this up.
Yeah, I can just stop and restart.
Is Altima recording?
I said yes, I said I can start and stop.
Well, yeah, you said that,
yeah,
but did you actually start it? You said I can start and stop and start it, but you didn't say I'll start it.
I said I am recording, I said I can stop and start it again if
you
want me to.
Oh, so you're recording.
I have been recording for like 10 minutes.
Jesus Christ, you two just need to fucking get married and get it over with.
Welcome to Snupsters.
Well, he did just recently have a divorce with me, so he's available.
Strangely enough, he's available, yeah.
What, I think Nico's trying to say something. We should all pipe down and get him
I'm the only one who can interrupt people around these.
No, you're not the only one.
I'm the only one. I'm not the only one. That's not a real song.
I know what my intro is going to be. I'm muting 2.5D.
Oh my god.
Let's do the precursor. I think this is a great game. I love the concept of Mega Man 2.
I'll take that out.
Mega Man 2 is the best game ever. So by adding a half a Mega Man between Mega Man 2 and 3, I think they nailed it.
I
don't know where the D came from. I'm assuming that's just a typo.
Real and Nico's right. My favorite game is it.
Welcome to Mega Man. Welcome to Mega Man. It crosses the line where it becomes not funny. Welcome to Mega Man 2.5D. The Snupsters, we'll take a look at it.
That's about all we'll do.
We're gonna play the game for half an hour and then tell our experience about it for another half an hour.
So what we're gonna do is, we're gonna play the game, we're gonna give our thoughts on it, and we'll tell you what we all think. And just like Mighty No. 9, this might just be... it's a game.
Well, if you wanna see our review of the game, click this box. If you don't want to see us play the game for half an hour.
Yep. And just warning, if you want to do anything without any knowledge, don't watch this video yet.
Why did they open it in the first place?
I'm Candy Bars, and Altima is driving me to drink tonight.
I'm Nico, and I bought a wooden whistle, but it wouldn't whistle. So I bought a steel whistle, but it still wouldn't whistle. So I bought a lead whistle, but it still wouldn't let me whistle. So I bought a tin whistle. Now I can whistle.
Wow. Okay.
You broke Fellon. Fellon's still trying to process it.
I'm supposed to do an intro, so I'm Fellon, and I just did an intro.
I like your enthusiasm for Snupster.
Okay, fine. How about this? I'm... That's it. I'm done. I was really trying to be enthusiastic. I got right at the very beginning there, and it just tapered off.
Well, I guess that just leaves me. I'm Altima. What would you call a company that makes women's vibrators? You would call it Genital Electric.
Only people in America would get that.
Only deal. America will get that one.
No, I'm smiling. General Motors. Yes. Go!
I pressed.
New game. Normal.
The first thing I want to ask you is, did you guys play the mobile games?
Nope.
Mobile games?
I don't play trash.
I would need some sort of tactile response before I could play. And
yeah.
You can do that with the phone.
I think what they thought was that they saw the Super Mario Run that was made for mobile. And they were like, okay, let's release Mega Man 1 through 6 on the mobile. Only difference, those games were not made for the platform.
I just died already. Nice.
And that's like... did you see the FPS on those? It's like 2 frames a second.
Say, Megaphil played them, didn't he?
I think so, yeah. I can't play games on mobile. Mobile.
Mobile. Folks in Alabama will love you.
What? You're like playing on a windmill? A mobile?
Like, that's like the worst idea
that
ever.
Sucks.
Play Mega Man on mobile.
Yeah.
fucking mobile. Mobile.
I very much question what they were... Well, I know what they were thinking. It was a cash grab, but...
Yeah. Because Super Mario Run was made for the mobile phones.
Oh, goddamn. There's stuff in the foreground that, like, blocks the screen. That's messed up.
We can just pick whatever the fuck stage we want, right?
Sure.
No, there's an order to this, and you will play in the order we
you
choose.
You will play the stage we tell you to play, Altima. You will play Quick Man.
Yes.
How about...
over and over and
how
over
about...
again.
Listen, I have some vice grips here. I bet you put your balls in them. I'll squish them into a fucking pancake.
And if somebody just tuned in for the first time for a Snupster video, this is what we're all about.
This Fuck is shoot. Us on a normal basis.
If you didn't see the disclaimer at the beginning, well, I just told you about it. Don't just skip
There's it. There's a disclaimer? Shit, I didn't read this before I started playing.
Exactly.
Hey, fish, get fucked!
Hey,
that's not
well, that
totally hey,
tells us where you are.
I don't know. Where the fuck am I? Where could I be?
Texas.
And you're in Snupster.
I am. I'm glad that you
I have a little, riddle for you. What's red? Swings back and forth and cries.
Whoa, what the?
Dead baby
Whoa.
In a swing set? I don't know.
Whoa,
that's
okay,
pretty
that's...
close. It's a baby on a meat hook.
Oh,
that's so close.
If you make a screen transition where it changes, like, does that turn thing, and you try to go back, you can't go back.
No, you die.
Yep, you just go right off the edge.
Deserved.
Deserved.
Well,
that's yeah. That
so
was almost as good as
huh?
my dead babies in the tub joke.
In the tub.
You know, I don't know. It's a pretty close tie there between you and him now.
It's a competition right now.
Fellon,
oh, yeah.
The patron of good taste, is careful to point that out.
Oh, now that's fun. Your cancel button is your jump button.
Yeah, but it's kind of weird.
Okay, so here's the problem. Your cancel button is your jump button. So when you try to cancel out of a menu, you jump. Which means you jump into spikes. Don't like that.
Okay. Oh my god.
How many people would catch that reference?
I do, actually.
We've died in the past.
Then again, I'm old, so...
Yes.
Not as old as Fellon.
Or candy.
Why do you guys make this a competition?
Yeah, I'm not really anxious to be the oldest Snupster, which I think I am, because I think Phil is still younger than
Well, you know, you burn 1,000 bridges, but suck one cock, you're gonna know as the cocksucker. It only makes sense.
I've heard that joke.
It's not a joke.
Oh, it was in reference to a sheep fucker when I heard it. Or a goat fucker.
What's the difference?
Well, one's got lots of wool and the other doesn't.
One they doesn't both have peanut equal... butter.
Oh yeah, peanut butter. Good one.
Isn't that, has anybody ever figured out what the peanut butter's for when a dog's licking your nuts?
Go watch Snupsters episode 6 from 2015.
Yeah. Oh god.
To find
was it really that long ago? It was.
Yeah, it was. Yes.
Oh.
It Whoa. Was quite a long time ago.
What do you mean, long time? 2015 is still in our hearts. It's the year no celebrities actually died.
No one important died that year.
Yeah, that's what I was always wondering. Why do you make such a big thing about it? It's just people. Well, everyone dies at some point.
Because yes, they're famous.
But they're famous, and...
What do you mean famous?
Maybe people like their movies and want to commemorate them.
Okay. Makes a lot of sense to me.
Maybe you just need to shut the hell up and keep playing your damn game.
Yeah. Fucking idiot. God.
Yeah. Game. Yeah.
Say no game.
Oh. Okay, let's be honest. Nico hates whatever we're playing, right?
Always. This is a normal thing.
I'm not saying a thing.
So, does he hate us then?
No.
I thought we were friends.
Wait, that means he has to be playing us though. Nico! Stop playing me. I know I'm getting a divorce from Fellon, but God!
What are you talking about getting a divorce? It's already finalized.
Since when?
It takes it takes 6 months for it to finalize.
We're in the age of the internet. Everything's instant now.
The age of the internet. Just get married and divorce at the same day.
Yep.
Work for Britney Spears.
Didn't she shave her head?
Yeah, she did.
Yes.
She got better.
She got better. Are you meaning she looked better?
If you're into cancer patients, sort of thing.
Oh. No. That's even worse than the previous one.
Oh, you got some explaining to do.
I don't think he does. He's a Snupster.
It's expect. Oh, I died.
It does seem like expected. I forgot to record.
Oh man, that joke's gonna slay when it goes out.
It's gonna slay, all
right. You mean just like the cancer, right?
I see what you did there.
So I asked this in a previous episode, like 5 episodes ago, but nobody acknowledged it. So I'm gonna ask again: which of you heard about the news of giant rats eating a baby?
I don't think anybody heard that. I think that we said that in the last episode, too.
I don't know. It was some third world country, but the mother actually left out for a drink and left her baby at home. And when she came back, the baby was eaten by giant rats.
Eaten alive or just
yeah, eaten alive. Like, you know the giant rats in those countries? They are like half the size of a baby. They just fucking ate the baby.
Now we're talking about rats, not dingoes, right?
Yes, rats. That's something. You come home and your baby is eaten. Then again, you shouldn't leave your home when you have a baby.
So what Never. Country am I avoiding from now on? With rats that big?
It does not from the Fallout lineup.
Megaton, it's like, that's a city you need to avoid.
Yes, I fucking hate that city. I didn't even pretend
it's
to know
it's one
what
of those cities
slash,
that's
you know.
Not been used in a Fallout game yet.
Yes.
That really actually. Probably should be already. Either that or somebody like tried to literally make Princess Bride.
Princess.
It's like the R-O-U-S's.
Rodents of unusual size.
I didn't think they existed until Nico told his story.
Have you ever ordered anything from UPS? Or like ordered something UPS delivers?
Yeah. UPS, can I order something from you? No, we just deliver.
Don't.
But I really want to order something from you.
can I get a pizza and double toppings, double cheese?
We are a delivery service, damn it.
I did deliver. I was being delivered something before Christmas. And they asked me when I'm home. And I said, after 5 p.m. So I came home 4 p.m. And then at like 9 p.m. I was like, okay, they're probably not gonna come. So I called them and I was like, where the fuck are you? And then then the guy in the phone was like, okay, it was trying to be delivered at 4:30 p.m. And I was like, wait, what the fuck you said after 5? Oh, I'm sorry. But then I told them I was home at 4 p.m. So I should have like heard the doorbell. So they never fucking rang the doorbell. So I just went in the pickup spot and got it myself then, because they can't even do their job.
Listen, is this story going to end with Jehovah's Witnesses knocking at your door like they did to Candy that one time? Because if it does, I'm going to tell you to stop right there, because I've already heard this story.
That would have been better, actually.
That story would have been better when I told it.
Die, bitch! Having a close call, Nico?
No, actually not. Well, I didn't burn 1,000 bridges.
Did you walk 100 miles? Or 500 miles?
I don't know what a mile is.
Don't know what a mile is.
I know I'm gonna be the man.
I love you.
Sorry. Musical Moments by Cat
Bars. Okay, so you've heard of those things called kilometers, right?
Yes, because we fucking use them.
No, we don't. Nobody uses those.
Nobody important, anyway.
Everyone but the US. Kilometers. Yes.
So, a kilometer is actually only 0.6 of a mile. Did you know
that? That's what I've always wondered. Why do you leave the zero out? Why is it okay to say point? Like 0.6? Why don't you say 0.6?
Because the zero means nothing. That's what zero is! It is nothing, Nico!
No, it is something because it exists and you talk about it.
No, it doesn't exist. Zero is nothing. Zero is a meaningless number. It is a lie.
Are you zero, Altima?
I am.
There is
zero.
No cow level.
Oh my god.
Hello, Time Man.
Fucking cow level, man.
Don't have a cow, man. The new robot master. Let's make field designs.
I'm still waiting for my platforms only Iceman stage.
Full folder zone.
Fuck that. Excuse me while I, totally hang myself.
What do you mean, totally hang yourself? How can you...
No, it's totally hang yourself, because what you're doing is you're using the tongue of a toad to hang yourself.
Didn't they, like, hang, like, the assistant of Saddam Hussein wrong or something? They just, like, snap his neck or something.
That's what you're supposed to do when you hang somebody.
They're not supposed to snap their neck. I mean, like completely behead them.
Oh,
I think.
A lot of times in hangings like that, they choke to death.
Yeah, but... He actually got beheaded.
Well, good for him. It's better than he deserved.
Yeah.
Normal death was too good for him.
Oops, we did it wrong. Doesn't matter now, the guy's dead.
Oh god.
Well, what does it fucking matter?
Oh, you fucking...
Don't you know how to kill the guy? Here, let me show you how to kill the guy. No, I know how to kill the guy.
Welcome aboard,
this is
Fellon.
All my summer job.
Well, it's the last time we let the intern do the hanging.
If you ask me, I think that should be the norm. Or maybe even slower and more painful. God, slowly, oh, wow. Slowly hit him with Mega Man Cross Street Fighter.
I don't know. Ask. Hey, Candy, are you retarded?
Well,
isn't that like a term used for science or something?
It's a scientific term, I guess. I mean, you can retard something. It means that you slow it down.
Don't you fucking use science in here.
Like, okay, on a serious note, the word retard is used in kitchens.
Yes.
We have something called a retarder when I used to work at a pizza. Like, no joke, it's called a retarder.
Yeah, we have a retarder in Snupster. Good guess who it is, right?
Would that be Nico?
Careful there with your words. Words can't hurt me. My weakness is not words.
What is your weakness?
Bad games.
Well, I think we scored a critical hit. I mean, I mean, all of the stuff we do is pretty much a critical hit, right?
Yes.
All of them. Everything is terrible, and you should all feel terrible.
I don't feel terrible.
No, you feel flashy. Da 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 da.
Like I knew that I would.
Da 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 da.
I feel good.
Da 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 da.
Knew that I would now.
Da da.
So good.
Da da.
So good.
Dun dun.
I got you.
Dun 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 dun.
I'm trying to sleep here.
I can't believe you went like full on with it.
We went the whole way with it.
You never go full retard.
From the beginning, how long can you do the I'm blue lyrics?
That's
a Scatman song.
I'm the scat man.
Hey, listen up. Here's a story about a little guy who lived in the blue world.
And all day and all night.
Everything he sees is just blue, like him.
It's gonna work.
Inside and outside.
Blew his house with a blue little window.
And a blue Corvette.
And everything is blue for him.
And himself.
And everybody around, because he ain't got.
He's got nobody. To listen.
To listen. I'm
blah, 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 blah.
This video is now banned in Mars.
Yeah. How many?
It's banned in Italy because they were from Italy. See how that works.
I was gonna say.
Group called Eiffel 65 from Italy.
What did you say?
How are you gonna have a group called Eiffel 65 and they'll be from Italy?
I don't know.
He's like, I didn't name the band, I don't
but
know.
But it was rhetorical, what did she say?
Yes, rhetorical.
That's
it was
what
it was ironic.
No, I was sarcasming you.
I was learning English, sarcasm so hard.
You're screwing me up. Learn the English. You're literally causing me to be more retarded.
What do you mean more?
You fucking...
Oh, hey, my first boss.
Oh, I'm going to die.
I wish you did.
Why is this game so god-awful?
I'll take that out.
Did you know
the game is pretty fun if you are blind? I'll take that out. I'll just take everything out that's in it. I'll take the whole episode out. Who cares? Nobody's gonna watch this.
Oh,
wait, but
do it.
If they hear us talking about it and it's on YouTube, how can you take it out? You can't untake it.
Yes, you can. Watch it.
Release it to begin with.
Once it's on the internet, it's always on the internet. You know the rule.
You know the rule, and so do I. Do I? A full commitment. What I'm taking off.
So we're just gonna turn this into Snupster the Musical.
I'm okay
oh,
with
neat.
It. Neat means.
Oh, neat.
That's pretty appropriate for this one.
Mm-hmm.
It's like,
hello,
what
time
you,
man. We meet again.
What do you call a very clean Nico?
No such thing. Don't lie.
Hit me.
Oh, that was beautiful. So, what do you call a very clean Nico? You call him a Neatco.
I liked that one.
Okay,
can I,
so
can I use it?
There's bad puns and then there's just bad jokes.
Well, what's the difference, really?
The others are told by Fellon.
The good puns are, well, obviously not told by me. But at least they'd rather listen to a bad pun than a bad joke.
Hey, I killed somebody.
Oh?
Your soul.
I have no soul.
Did she have a family?
No.
That's why he has, like, 5 exes. Just killed them all. I see. Where is it?
Where is it?
Okay. Oh, okay, I'm digging. Okay.
Hi!
Sorry.
Put that trumpet away, we don't need it. So you actually play the trumpet, right?
I play the trombone.
So you
play
the trumpet.
There's a difference.
What was your decision to go play the trumpet?
You mean the trombone?
The trumpet, yes.
Everybody else on the block was doing it.
Everyone else on the block was playing the fucking trumpet.
Yep. I'm being dead serious. That's why I started playing the trombone.
Everyone else on the block was playing the trumpet.
Yes.
So if the trumpet jumped off a bridge, would you jump off the bridge too?
Yeah.
Evidently.
If everyone else played Mega Man, would you play as well?
Well. Oh, that's... Yes, I would have.
I don't have the lungs for the trumpet.
No, you don't.
I don't have the lungs for fucking anything. I'm a failure.
I used to have the lungs to sing, and then I stopped singing. So.
Can we get a highlight on that? I want a highlight on that.
I don't have the lungs to suck a cock.
Oh, no, I'm a failure. I want a highlight on that.
Well, we've been saying that for a long time. Thanks. I'm glad you finally noticed, Fellon. I mean...
Muy divertido. Muy verdadero. So I guess we're lucky that we got this game because Capcom didn't take it down yet.
Yes.
Capcom's not bad about taking games down.
Are you seeing
Mario,
all the sprites that are being used here?
That's Nintendo that's bad about it.
Yeah, Nintendo doesn't care about the audience. Wait, hold on. They're having fun? No, we must stop this. They can only
stop
have
the
fun
madness.
Playing our games.
Stop the madness.
They're making videos of our game showcasing the fun? Fuck this. We'll take half the money.
Get
no,
the fuck
we'll take
out
all the money.
Here.
Give us all the money.
Well, you know what? They deserve something for their time. We'll give them
0.01%. No, they don't. Nintendo, eat a dick. There, I said it.
What the fuck's Nintendo? Oh, it's the same. It's the cousin of 4chan.
It's the cousin of 4chan. Oh, you asshole. You made me die.
I made you die.
Yes, I blame you.
Was it a bad joke?
Yes, it was a terrible joke.
I didn't hear no joke.
It was.
I heard a joke. Nico Thulin.
Prince of Bel Air. Do you know the song for that one?
Yes, I can do that one top to bottom.
Okay, do it.
hang on a second. I gotta think about it.
It failed.
In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing and relaxing all cool, and shooting some b-ball outside the school, when a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood.
Your video is muted in the hood.
And my mom got scared. She said, you're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air.
Your video is muted in Bel Air.
Whistle for a cab, and when he came near, the license plate said fresh, and he had dice in the mirror. If anything, I can say that this cab was rare, and I said, oh man, forget it. Yo, Holmes, the Bel Air.
You fucking killed me.
I pulled up to the house about seven or eight, and I yelled to the cabin, yo, Holmes, smell you later. I looked at my king, and I was finally there. I sat on my throne as the Prince of Bel Air.
I have cancer. I have cancer. Actually, hang on, let me check. I don't think I have cancer hard enough.
You're gonna fucking feel bad when you actually get it.
Take me now.
Take me now.
Take me down.
Take me to your leader. You have no power here.
Oh, man. Such quality entertainment.
Yeah.
Welcome to Snupster. Where we give no fucks about anything.
I give some.
Oh my god!
You deserved it.
Did you know Mega Man 2 is everyone's favorite game?
Yes.
Except mine.
Because you are mentally handicapped.
But every time I ask what the reason for that is, nobody knows the answer.
I can tell you why.
Well, fucking tell me.
Because it is the greatest
horrible
game.
Person. You are a horrible person, Nico.
Because you're a Mong.
How is 2 people. Better than 4?
Because it has better music, it has better controls, has better robot masters.
Better controls? 4 is like perfect.
4 is pretty damn perfect for controls. But
4
2,
is pretty damn
so I think, 4, the thing is like 4 and 2 have basically the same controls.
Basically, yes.
Only 2s are way better.
So the only argument against 4 is to just argue for fun.
No. You're stupid.
No, nobody really knows. I ask them why 2 is better than 4.
I just listed a shit ton of reasons why 2 is better
than
4.
They all sucked.
No. Just because you don't agree with them doesn't make them not true. Snupster fans, back me up here. We have a comment below.
Comment below.
And tell Nico why he's wrong.
How about we just tell Nico why he's never right?
Better? Even better. Tell us why Nico is never right.
I don't like the... there we go. Okay. This is kind of stupid. Sorry, I have to talk about it. I'm pretty sure we're nearing our limit here.
Yeah, 2.5 minutes. Wish I was playing the 3D NES emulator.
I'm getting some serious lag. I think it's just my recording software, though. Yep.
I'd like to thank Nico for backing me up on the music there when I was doing my Fresh Prince of Bel Air.
No problem.
I was just letting you have your moment there. Didn't want to interrupt. I mean, I just let you have your moment there.
Have your moment.
Did you know having a moment is good for your health?
Yes.
Of course it doesn't work the same.
Of course!
Better edit that out.
Yes. All right, that was easy.
Oh, you are different. You are so different. Oh,
I'm
not painfully different.
No, I'm not.
You got a new weapon. You got a new review.
You got
a new job because Snupster just kicked you out.
Job? I don't even get paid for this shit.
Right? Nico, where's our money?
Where's my royalties? Money. You're using the,
Yeah, where's my motherfucking royalty check?
Yeah, where's the, I want to know where my royalties are. You are using the Altima Mantoid name.
Royalty.
Royalty. So delicious.
He'll give you your royalties when you wear that crown you so deserve.
Mean tiara?
Tiara.
That'll pronounce it right. Fine.
Oh, no way in hell am I doing that.
Oops. Ooh. Wasn't me. That wasn't me.
Mm-hmm.
Don't you believe me?
Nope.
That's ridiculous.
All right, let's see how bad this is.
Oh, I was like one hit away from winning. Victory was assured.
Time's up.
I'm going to finish this Robot Master.
I'm going to finish this stage.
Yeah, same. Whoa, what the?
I just game over, so never mind. I can just hear the stick.
How many did you knock out before
I knocked one.
Time up?
Oh, I died. Okay.
I think I knocked out four or something.
I knocked out two. Or was in the process of getting two.
I was playing it yesterday.
I was about to say, I think you've been playing this before.
I played this yesterday, yes. Because I wanted to actually give good feedback.
Yeah, you go for it.
So before I let the others tell their experience, I'd like to start because I'm usually the odd one out. Usually people disagree with me.
We disagree with you all the time, so there's nothing different there.
So first off, I reviewed the Beta 4 on my channel a few years back. I think it's been like 2 years already. And I complained a lot about the problems it had. I'm glad that some of them got fixed in this version, which is good. This is the 1.0.1, I think. So if something I say is no longer true in the future, keep that in mind. The game looked pretty good back then. I think it's been like 8 years. I think it looked like a good idea. But as with all Mega Man fan games, it needs someone who understands how a Mega Man game should actually work and what makes them so good. I don't think this is the case here. I have some bigger problems listed, and I'll go through them as quickly as possible. Alright, so teleporting the stage sometimes misses the animation, and shooting while landing also seems to cancel some animations. It doesn't matter if he worked for 8 years on this, missing animations in the final build is just pure laziness in my eyes. Some enemies have straight up awful hitboxes, most of them almost, I think, have double the hitbox height. For example, if you try to jump over the scorpions in Ferroman stage, you see the problem clearly. I'm not sure how you don't notice this when developing a game. If this is like a game engine's limitation, it's just quite disheartening. I've seen items drop through the death spikes. When I like to get items, I get hit in purpose, and then I find out, oh, item goes through the spikes, and I'm dead. The enemy designs, they're used from the original Mega Man games, but they have been altered on their AI. And this results in confusion amongst the veteran players. No matter how good you are, even with the Buster only no miss, you're gonna get hosed on some bosses by default. Don't have like Tornado Man doing weird homing landings, don't make Pharaoh Man not shootable from the upper platform, don't make Snake Man little snakes faster, and so on. This is extremely frustrating. If you like use the old designs for bosses but make them a new AI, how does that make any sense from a developing standpoint? And how is this fun for the core audience? For example, I found out that the Chos who spawn facing left, you can shoot through their shields, and the ones who spawn facing right, you can't. I was able to figure out this out in like 10 seconds. I fail to see how that's a design choice, it's probably a bug. And bosses like Starman seem completely broken because of how their shield works. Well, using the word works quite loosely. Sliding. Unresponsive and frustrating. I think this game actually has the same problem as Mega Man 6. It has the jump mechanics, it cancels your jump. That's one of the bigger issues I have with the game. The sliding just doesn't work well.
But I never seem to have too much of the issue with the slide that you guys are having, so I'm going
I didn't notice anything with the slide.
I'm going to have to assume that's probably a controller issue, which seems to afflict the Xbox controllers on a lot of this stuff.
Could be. Yeah, I mean, I can't be out on Xbox controllers.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I was watching Mike Matei's little run through the game, and he also runs on an Xbox controller and had the exact same issue it sounds like you guys are describing. Hmm. So it sounds like an engine problem with those controllers, or let's be honest, it's the Xbox controllers.
UI doesn't scale with your resolution, it's way too small. And to add to this, a true 4x3 resolution isn't possible. It's only available in widescreen, which I can see how that's probably not a problem for most, but it's just something I noticed. Ladders. You can't grab the absolute bottom of a ladder. How does this pass testing for 8 years? It's beyond me. Controls. I already told about the sliding. Very unresponsive and inputs are being eaten a lot. Not sure why this is such a huge problem in the game. The 3D effects. While nice, they kind of make you feel like you're walking off the edge when the game is waiting for you to go far enough on the screen. So it gets like the transition done, and it switches angles. Like, I always think I'm about to drop down, but apparently I was waiting for the screen to transition. Enemies, inconsistent and buggy. For example, the clown platforms, the hovers from Ferroman stage, very glitchy. Sometimes I like drop through and sometimes I just jump repeatedly on them without actually pressing anything. It's okay for a game to have bugs, but when you encounter bugs almost every run through on something you have to pass through every time, such as these platforms, it becomes extremely frustrating and really showcases the lackluster game development. And a minor quirk, the menu buttons are backwards, so shoot is select and jump is not. I think Altima mentioned this when we were playing. Something's like wrong with the button layout, I'm not sure what it is. And one of the bigger problems, because the screen estate is so big, because it's widescreen, the three-shot rule doesn't play in the game's favor. Like, having three shots on the screen at once makes the game feel off and punishes you a lot for missing. Add, like, moving targets, shitty hitboxes, and the AI that doesn't match the original games. It sinks the experience. It is a Mega Man staple, three shots on the screen, but for widescreen, just doesn't work. And I think the game relies too much on weapon weaknesses for the bosses. Typical buster runs throw you off because the enemy AI has been altered. And if you're trying to implement the same strategies for the bosses as you want on the NES games, easily results in a game over because they don't work the same. Whether this is a design choice or not, it's just weird. And about the 2.5D effect, most of the time I actually forgot it's there. I just played the game and didn't even notice. And also, I found this weird bug. Sometimes when you die just before a checkpoint, it still starts you at the checkpoint when you come back to life. And at that point, you're pretty confused when the game drops you somewhere you haven't seen before. This happens in Time Man stage at least, not sure about the others. And at no point does the game tell you that you can select Proto Man after selecting the boss. I just pressed up in an accident and found out that way. And the gameplay as a whole just feels shallow, it feels like you're not in full control. Honestly, the list goes on forever. Like, I'm not a very emotional man, but playing this game made me almost fucking cry. This game is like the very example why only people who understand the deep game mechanics should be making a Mega Man fan game. We don't need this game. We don't need fan games just for the sake of fan games, is what I think. Like, use your time for something else if you lack the knowledge. This is not a stab against the developer by any means, it's just my opinion. For those people with little to no experience on Mega Man games, should find this game okay, I think. But it's not aimed for those people, it's aimed for us. And this being the case, the game, I think, disappoints on all accounts. If I came up with something positive about the game, they would probably be overshadowed by all the negative aspects. The 2.5D aspect of the game is barely noticeable when playing. If anything, it makes the game worse because of all the problems I listed. You people at home watching this are probably thinking, who is he to talk about the game this way? But listen up, I'm literally the game's core audience, and I have free speech. So cue those dislikes, because I don't care what you think about my opinion. And I'm entitled to have one. If you want to play the game, just... Yes. If you want to play the game, just get it before Capcom takes it down, I guess. They're probably not gonna like all the sprites that are used and stolen, I guess. So, I found articles that are mostly praising the game. All probably written by dumbnuts who can't even make up an article themselves through actual research, but rather lousy copy and paste jobs, so I don't even have to care about those reviews either. Don't read the articles, just play the game yourself and make a decision if you like it or not. Don't take my word for it. Thank you for the game, but it's not for me and I don't know who it's for. Sorry to say, but for me, I think this game is worse than Mega Man Cross Street Fighter. I'm done.
And that's saying something.
Ouch.
I've not had anywhere near the experience of this game that Nico has. I did run through this game briefly with him when he tested the beta as well, and I had a very negative opinion of it then. I thought the idea of the 2.5D was a very novel thing, and I still do. I think it's kind of a neat effect, but it doesn't really bring anything to the game. In fact, it takes away from it. As Nico pointed out, the hitboxes are all jacked up in this game. Mega Man's hitbox is bigger, and it seems like all the enemies have smaller ones, which means in areas where you would ordinarily feel comfortable standing in a regular 2D Mega Man, you try to stand there in the 2.5D, and you're going to wind up getting hit. And I don't know if this is because the perspective changes and it just throws everything off, but I think as neat as the idea was, it caused more problems than it solved. The controls did not feel comfortable at all. It felt sticky. It felt like I was slogging through the mud, and Mega Man was not very responsive. The three-shot rule, again, like Nico pointed out, does not work in its favor. I constantly find myself rushing to get out of the way of something where I thought I should have been able to shoot, and I realized, oh crap, I can't because I still have three bullets on the screen. It was really frustrating.
I do have to mention, they did fix a lot since the Beta 4 on the controls, but it's still not enough. It's still, like on mud, as you said.
The AI being different, I didn't get to play through enough of it to really notice a lot of that. I noticed a little bit when I fought Starman. My regular Starman strategy had no effect whatsoever, and it felt like his shield was further out than it should be, and just, I don't know. The Sniper Joes were really frustrating because they don't have a large enough shot window to effectively attack them, so you can either force yourself to take a hit and kill them quickly, or you can sit there for 5 minutes and get one, maybe two shots in. It's just really stupid. I'm not at all happy with this. Probably never play it again unless another version comes out where some changes have been made, but
that's the thing. Like, when I was playing this yesterday, I was like, I don't want to play this. Like, even for this review, I didn't want to play this.
Well, even when we as Snupsters, were toying with the idea of going back over this, I felt a sense of dread because I remember how things were in the demo. And yes, it is somewhat improved from the demo, and I honestly do hope that someone plays this game and enjoys it. And it sounds like at least a few people do. But like Nico said, the core audience, the people who spend so much time playing Mega Man that they know the ins and outs of how all the... They don't just know the physics engine of one, they know the physics engine of all the games and how they relate to one another. And anyone who plays any of those can tell you this is bullshit. It's a game, and that's... I know we use that phrase on Mighty No. 9. It's a game, and that's about the best I can say about it.
First impressions, it looks clean. Like, the graphics... I mean, yeah, they're taken from the actual Mega Man games, but when you add in that half a dimension... like, when you can see the sides of the platforms, it looks clean, graphically speaking. The controls, the jumps feel a little off, like, they...
It seems like you're sticked to platforms.
Yeah, I noticed when I was going through Splash Woman stage, like, as soon as I let go of jump, I was dropping. So, it's kind of reminiscent of what they did with Mega Man 3's jump. And that's not the kind of jump I like. 2, 4, and 1 have that quote-unquote perfect jump. So the jumps, if you aren't expecting to just start dropping like a rock, yeah, you might be in for a bad time. From what I could tell, like, the bosses are tweaked, their AI is tweaked just a little bit. Like Splash Woman, she's much faster. When she's doing her laser tridents downwards, she's going back and forth at like 100 miles an hour, and it's total such a totally sharp contrast.
Can I tell you something in between? When you fight Tornado Man, he works almost exactly the same, but when he's about to land next to you, he actually homes on you and hits you, even if you're not in its line of fire. That's kind of like, why the fuck would you do that?
It's like it's making the game difficult for no reason.
Yeah, for no reason at all. Go ahead.
All right. So, but let me compare real quick, because I only beat two bosses, and I'm got close to the Gate of Starman's while Nico was talking. But with, like I was saying, you know, Splash Woman goes back and forth dropping laser tridents really fast, but Quick Man did not really seem that fast. I don't know if that was intentional, or if that's just not, you know, if that was them toning down Quick Man, or what. I mean, Quick Man's supposed to be a pain in the ass. And, yeah, he killed me once, but I was expecting him to just jump all over the place, and he didn't do that. So, he was kind of slow about it. There was, like, one jump where he just, I mean, it was almost like he teleported across the screen. He was that fast. So, it was very inconsistent. The fight was too frantic for me to really grasp his AI to compare it to the original. One other thing I do want to point out, talking about the hitboxes that Nico mentioned, the walkers in Starman's level, you can shoot over their heads with the laser trident and still hit them. I noticed that just by chance. So that was...
It's because most of like the enemies, they have double the hitbox for some reason. There's like an empty space on top of each enemy.
It's... I'm not sure... Like... Maybe that's the case, maybe it's not, I don't know.
I did test it yesterday, I bumped to like every enemy in the game pretty much.
I have to admit, I do like the puzzles that they had. Well, you know, in the two levels I got to play, the force beams in Quick Man's level, they did feel natural. They did feel like they flowed pretty natural, so I have to give props there. I liked the usage of the bubbles combined with spikes in Splash Woman's level. My biggest complaint, and it got me killed once, and that's why it's probably my biggest complaint, is when you go into the menu, like, I'm in the menu right now, so, because I paused it, if you press the jump button is your cancel button, if you cancel out of your menu, you jump. So if you're in a water area with spikes above you, and you press that cancel button to get out of the menus, you jump right into spikes and kill yourself. That shouldn't even be a thing. That should not happen. Also, I am in similar sentiment. I agree with 3-shot limit. While I understand it is keeping to the core gameplay of Mega Man, 3 shots is not doable in a widescreen setting. Maybe if you could set it to, like, this, you know, 3x4x3, you know, the traditional square. 3 shots is perfect, because you have less screen real estate to work with, you're not crossing, like, a mile of platforming before your shots go off screen. And... Not to mention, it also suffers from Mega Man 5 syndrome in the fact that enemies seem to have invulnerability frames. So you can't just mash the buster as fast as you want. And even if you could, why would you? You got a 3-shot limit on a widescreen. I will probably finish this game, because I think... Oh, and before I go any further with that thought, I wanted to mention the 2.5D. I like it. I agree with Candy. It is a novel idea. It's very cool. And like I said, graphically, the 2.5D is very crisp. It looks very clean. I like it. It's very visually eye-popping. And I think that's maybe what the developers were going for. They wanted that eye-pop. They wanted it to draw you in. They have done an amazing job of that. But during a screen transition, where it does the screen wrap and it moves the camera and you change directions and all of that, it's fine. Like, it's a pretty smooth transition. My problem is that you can't go back. If you go to the, like, if you scroll right and when it turns the camera and it pans you to the next area, you can't go back. You'll go right to your death. And that makes no sense, considering you just came from the other direction. Like, I mean, granted, I don't think it's a bad game. It's definitely worth a playthrough if you like Mega Man at all. To me, anyway. You know, varying opinions. But to me, I think if you like Mega Man, and it's definitely good for a casual player. casual, you know, just pick it up. Hey, this game's fun. I want to try it out. Pretty good. I mean, it'll definitely keep you busy. It'll probably... I'm sure there's some frustrating points. I haven't seen that many. But when it comes to somebody that is a super dedicated, hardcore Mega Man fan who knows the franchise mechanics inside and out for all of the classic series and some of the X series, the changes are a bit sharp in contrast as to what you have and what you've grown accustomed to. So, it's not bad. It's not as good as I was hoping it would be. I went in hoping that this would be, like, just floor me. And some of it has floored me. Again, the eye-popping 2.5 dimension. Again, I've used the word before. It's very clean, very crisp, and I like that. But it falters in the mechanics, and that's something that is incredibly crucial, especially to a platformer, and especially even more so to a platformer like Mega Man, where you have those precision jumps, where you have to make those precise shots. Having bigger hitboxes may be a fault of the engine, or where it's that 2.5D. Maybe that has something to do with it. But if you're going to make a hitbox, you know, at least try to be consistent with the enemy's area.
I think the problem here is mostly that this game is not finished. Even though it's mentioned that it is, but I think maybe this was too much.
I think it's finished enough to be, and that's, again, patches. They can fix things with feedback, and that's one good thing about modern gaming, is if some, you know, a lot of people don't like something, or, you know, if there's an outcry, or, you know, whatever, it can be patched. That is a good thing. Because let's look at Mega Man 3, shall we? Not to rag on Fellon's favorite game. That game is incredibly unpolished. You can't patch it. It's done. It's released. You can't fix it. But with this, you know, feedback, you know, if there's something bothering you, contact the developer, make a video about it. I have to give this about the same rating I gave Mighty No. 9, honestly. Maybe a little bit more. Like, I gave Mighty No. 9 right at about a 7. I'd have to give this about a 7.5 out of a 10. It's great. I'll finish the game, and I'm sure I'll play it, you know, more after that. It's definitely good, and I think, counter to Nico, after Street Fighter Cross Mega Man's been out so long, I think this is actually better than Street Fighter Cross Mega Man.
Ouch.
The longer Street Fighter Cross Mega Man is out, the more I start to dislike that game. It has great weapons. It's just... But I didn't have a whole lot of problems with the AI in this game. Other than, you know, other than what I mentioned, I thought enemies, you know, acted, you know, pretty good with the environments and stuff like that. Oh, the last thing, speaking of the AI, why is returning Sniper Joe fire no matter what you do?
Oh, yeah, that was something else I was going to talk about. He doesn't stand still if you jump when he lands.
And that's, I think that's all I have to say.
Fellon, take us home, man.
I think this is a fantastic game. And you're all just, okay. I think you guys went in with high expectations. This definitely is not the original game. There's no question about it. And to expect the exact original game is probably next to impossible. But what they have done is pretty dang good. Though there's definitely some polish that could be done to make it better. And yes, you know, when you say it doesn't feel right or it could be better, things like that, that's not input, right? Input such as...
I'm curious why Unlimited did it so well. It's not impossible.
It's... How should I say? I don't know. There definitely is a... Like, for example, right on the section I was on right now, the bubble bats feel like they're a little bit too slow, but then again, you know, you have two different versions to take your your data from. You know, Mega Man 2, they were really slow, but Mega Man 4, they were actually a bit faster. It's trying to do a lot of things at once, and I do... See, I can't quite put them into words because I don't want to come off as... I want to actually, you know, try to go on its merits, which it has many definitely good merits.
Oh, yeah, it has many. Is it a perfect game?
There was a bug I forgot to mention, and I saw it just a second ago, and I wanted to mention it real quick, not to cut you off, Fellon. When you jump and get hit on the same frame, you skyrocket into the air.
Yes, I saw that.
There's definitely a timing issue involved. Like, some things are perfect bang on. Other things, like... I want to say it's... Like, for example, getting hit, you don't get knocked back as far as you should in a typical Mega Man game. Some of the enemy behavior patterns, that such, are not an exact copy of them. Probably due to the fact that either A, they didn't study the AI, or B, they went on recollection of what they remember the AI to be, or C, which I think is more or less what they tried to do here, and that's they were trying to create... a variation, like sort of a remix of sorts of the original boss. Like, for example, let me go back on Shadow Man, for example. If you beat him, his fight actually does feel pretty close to the original fight, and it feels a lot closer to how the fight should be if he wasn't bugged. And yes, he is bugged. Small bugs, not like completely bugged, but he is partially bugged. Then you have Snake Man, who appears to be bugged in this version, in the sense that when he fires off his snakes, he continues to go in the direction that he was already going, therefore hitting a wall and then bouncing back. He should just change direction after he fires the snakes, I feel. Like, why would he continue to run into the wall? Like, small stuff like that. I mean, it's not a bad game at all, actually. I quite like the feel. Part of it is... feels empty, like there's long stretches of nothing. I guess that's mostly Splash Woman's stage. And then some stages feel like they have just the right amount. And in many regards, I don't think they overdid it. I think a lot of it has to do with what you said. It probably caters a lot more to the people who have memories but never really... sat down to, like, you know, analyze the AI, tried to do perfect runs, that kind of stuff. For those kind of people, they'll enjoy this game. It does bring back a lot of nostalgia for them.
For sure.
But unless they're actually, like, comparing it side by side, they probably won't notice the subtle differences. And I think that's where you're wrong, Nico. No offense, but I don't think this game was actually designed to cater to hardcore fans such as ourselves.
Okay.
So overall rating, I would actually give this game probably a 7 or 8 out of 10 for what it's trying to do. I'd probably
so
close
around
to 8.
Where I was.
Yeah, but I would definitely, there's some things that need to be tweaked in terms of enemy AI, adjusting the speed a bit, and maybe doing something about the fact that you do have a longer screen and your shots kind of being stuck on screen as you move forward kind of become a bit of a hindrance.
So
I'm a little surprised. I honestly thought it was going to be straight for up negative reviews, so that's interesting.
I think it was good. I think it's a good game. Like, I may be a little bit harsh on it, but I do think it is a good game. Two other things that I remember going through Starman's level again. Don't put an enemy in a spot when you have a foreground object that moves in front of you.
Yeah.
You can't see to hit it. Also, nobody talked about the music remixes. Did you like the remixes? Like, I mean, did you not like them?
I do. Like, it's not so much a remix as it is, well, I guess it is more akin to
a remix. It's like reimagining the songs a bit.
Yeah.
It is, yeah. So it is a remix. I was thinking more of, like, a range or something like that.
But I think that if they actually used their own sprites and own bosses and own enemies, this would have been... a lot better in my eyes.
Probably.
Because then you wouldn't know about the old mechanics. You would have something new, and they'd have new mechanics, and you wouldn't know about them.
Okay.
That's what it would have saved it in my eyes.
Speaking of new, Time Man has sprites. Time Man never had sprites.
That's also true. One of my biggest dreams has always been to have a copy of 8-bit Mega Man that had both Time Man and Oil Man in it, and this is one step in that direction. I thought it was pretty good.
I like the boss selection. I think that he did a good job you know, the crew did a good job picking bosses that represented the games. While there was no representatives from 10 and 9,
unless there's
or
a
not
secret,
9,
secret
I'm sorry,
boss.
10 and 6, 10 and 6, I mean, I don't think that was a big issue. I think they did do a good job of picking bosses that represented the franchise quite well. Especially picking Quickman. Like, he's probably the numero uno most memorable boss anybody has in this game.
I've heard there's a secret boss, so we don't know them all.
I also like that you can pick Proto Man. Yeah, it's a little bit hidden, but I do like that you can pick him.
But that I also already told everyone that my opinion is always different. I did say that.
Mm-hmm.
I think you're heavily critical just because you have an expectation. And this didn't live to your expectation, thus, therefore... It's not.
Therefore,
it's
I, have an opinion.
I do have an expectation. I know, and I'm pretty sure Nico does too. And it's, I don't think that's necessarily a bad thing. You know, we've been spoiled by games like Mega Man Unlimited or whatever. But you know, once that standard has been reached, it's kind of hard to take a step back.
Yeah, there's no excuse anymore. There is none. And it's
you get everyone loves Mega Man in a different way. And I know the people that make a lot of the fan games like Mega Man in their own way. They like, you know, creating their own magic in of it and stuff like that. And then they want to share that that love for Mega Man with everyone else. It's just when that love differs from your opinion that it becomes, you know, what it is right now.
Also, why can you select E-Tanks as a weapon?
That so you can accidentally use them.
Yeah, that's a real kind of stupid design. I don't know if that's a limit of the engine, and I'm probably going to peg that on that for sure.
And, of course, it's probably a fun hobby for the game developer to make this.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's definitely interesting. Like, I'm sure there were hurdles that had to be overcome, such as, you know, how to do this and how to do this and how to...
Oh, yeah. This was had to have been no easy feat to program at all. I'm not knocking... the developers one bit, but they're... I mean, it's not a perfect game by far.
But you know what? A for ever. I will give it an A for ever.
Yeah. Pat yourselves on the back, guys. It is, I think, a pretty good game. It's pretty solid. Just because I give it a 7.5 doesn't mean I think it's bad. I'm a stickler where 5 is an average game. So, whereas people say, you know, 5 is a bad game, I am a person that thinks 5 is, average. So... I think it's an above-average game. I think it is a solid piece of work. I like it.
I'm still going to keep my opinion, even though you say I'm wrong. I'm still going to keep it.
And that's your opinion to keep, you know? Nobody faults you for that.
You know what? It is your opinion, and that's fine to have one.
Well, yeah, your opinion is wrong!
We have no right to say your opinion is right or wrong, because that would therefore say you do not have an opinion.
Mm-hmm.
When I was playing this game yesterday, I just didn't want to continue. It's not that I'm making a show just for the sake of our show. I'm not, like, making a number here. I'm just being honest.
I think people want to know our opinion of it, and it's good that we did this when we did.
I agree.
Yep, next time you'll probably want to review a game without me.
You're very harsh, but somebody has to be a very harsh person.
Well, and you had a lot to say. I don't necessarily think that's a bad thing. I mean, I see Fellon's point of view as valid too. I mean, we did kind of go into it with a hypercritical eye, and I don't feel bad about that, but he's right.
Yeah, I mean, when you walk into a movie theater and expect a movie to, you know, live to expectations of its predecessor, and it doesn't, then it's a piece of shit movie. But if you walk into it and never saw the original, it's an okay movie. I mean, that's generally with anything.
Yeah, but it's Mega Man. Who's gonna play this game and never played Mega Man before?
Well, see, I felt the same way about Final Fantasy VII. If you had taken the Final Fantasy name off of it and named it something else, I would have thought the game was amazing. But because I was so born and raised on the first 6 Mega Man games where there was a style, there was a certain format, there were certain things I expected, when 7, you know, deviated from all that, I didn't like that.
In many regards, one could say that's why we don't like Mega Man 8. Because they deviated.
Except for me, I enjoy it.
No, you don't.
I do. I like Mega Man 8.
No, you hate it.
Perfect run it and then get back to me.
I will still like the game because I think as a casual game, it is a lot of fun.
That's because he's got Stockholm Syndrome.
The damn game earned more high scores than any other game series. You're right. You're allowed to have your opinion. Your opinion's wrong, but you're allowed to have your own opinion.
Yeah, I love that part. Fellon's like, you're wrong.
why does the bulldozer guys why do they go off of platforms?
I don't know. We quit playing a long time ago.
I saw that as well. It's just why everything.
Honestly, Shadow Man stage is probably like the easiest stage, and in fact, the boss fight was the easiest and most closely representative of Shadow Man.
Well,
if they made more stages like Shadow Man, I think they could have got a better review.
Well, we hope you guys enjoyed watching our review. Again, play it for yourself, formulate your own opinions, and feel free to share your input with us as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, don't read the articles, just play it yourself.
Yep, that's definitely. So, I guess Snupsters 2 like it and 2 don't, so it's just a game?
It's just a game.